Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. It's January 4th, 2016. It's the first trading day of 2016, and the Dow Jones Industrial Average was down by over 450 points. Pretty bad day for the market here in the U.S., even worse in China. I think the market was down by 6.5%. The circuit breakers kicked in. They actually had to shut down the entire market, which is pretty dire, to say the least. So we're getting off to a very rocky start in the trading for this year. It's just one day, so it's nothing to get excited about, but it's something worth noting. So, I mean, is this something that's actually foreshadowing what's going to come ahead for 2016? I don't know. Or maybe this is just an anomaly, a correction. But the stock is pretty high. The market's pretty high right now. So we'll see. 450 points doesn't mean the same thing as it would if we were at 10,000, obviously. So, yeah. So actually, the Dow Jones went down to 467 points. And it actually sort of recovered a little bit, but it still finished 275 points below the previous day. Although Germany's economy is actually at a record high. Actually, the employment, according to their statistics, because of a strong economy and because of immigration, apparently, the German employment is actually at a record high. Not unemployment, employment. So it's good news for Germany. And then there's a situation in Oregon. We have a situation where there's protesters, armed protesters, militia type guys, organization called the Citizens for Constitutional Freedom. They claim to be an organization that's designed to protect constitutional rights. Apparently, there's a lot of people who have participated in this event. It's essentially a bunch of armed guys, regular citizens, taking over government property, federal government property. Is a federal building, is a wildlife refuge building, and they're doing this because a lot of people believe that the office has been used to take over or infringe on a lot of people's property rights. And a lot of this has to do with the Hammonds. The Hammond brothers basically were convicted of arson because they set fire to some land, I think their own land, and they were trying to, well, at least they claimed that they were trying to prevent invasive species from getting onto their property. Turns out the federal government said that they were doing it to cover up poaching. Anyway, the fire got out of hand, so it became a serious problem. Looks like they're going to serve 5 years. There's going to be a 5-year sentence. They just turned themselves in to Harney County, to the Harney County Sheriff's Department in Oregon. So they've been trying to distance themselves from this situation, kind of. But a lot of people are supporting them. The big reason why a lot of people are upset is because after they were convicted, the government was pressuring them to sell their land. And when they didn't do that, then they were punished. A lot of people feel like they were punished because they didn't want to sell their land. So a lot of people feel like the government's infringing on their property rights, their constitutional rights. And you have a lot of ranchers basically saying that we've been working on this land since the early 1900s, and now the government's saying that we can't have this, we can't do this. The refuge has been expanding, and they're saying they're doing this at the expense of the ranchers. Well, Bundy, that rancher, was involved in a situation with the federal government where he was trying to use public land for his livestock. I mean, and he basically, it was almost like a standoff there too. But with that situation, I feel like if you're using federal property to earn a profit, then it makes sense for the federal government to have the right to actually charge you some type of fine or some type of fee. Just because you've been doing it, your family has been doing it for centuries, doesn't mean that you necessarily have the right to actually continue doing that. But that's just my perspective on things. I feel like if I got to pay taxes, everybody else should have to pay taxes too. But other people feel like, hey, you know, they've been there before the federal government was even involved in the situation. Why should they have to pay? I understand that perspective. Right here, do you think it's a good idea for these guys to be taking over a building with weapons? And the government can't just give them what they want, because if they do, then the federal government has to worry about the next group coming around and using the exact same tactic. So I don't see the government giving them what they want. I wonder how this whole situation is going to end. What do you think about these guys? What type of situation would make you feel like you would actually want to risk your life for a certain cause? Like, some of these guys, they're pretty much risking their lives here for this cause right here. I'm not really sure what they really want. I don't know if they want the sentence of the Hammonds to be reduced. I don't know if they're asking for a specific policy change. If you know that, please let me know. But what do you think about this situation? And how do you think it's going to end? All right, and question of the day, convicted felons. People who have been convicted of felonies, I've come across a number of people who have been convicted of felonies. Some of them actually turned their lives around. They stopped committing criminal acts. They stopped getting convicted. They started to become productive members of society. So should those people be able to protect their families by owning firearms, buying firearms legally? Does the government even have the constitutional right to prevent people from owning firearms if they've been convicted of a felony? We have a sex registry. If someone's been convicted of child molestation or some type of criminal sexual assault, does the government have the right to impose lifelong penalties in that sense? I mean, because if you're going to say that it's okay for the government to force people to register under certain situations, then provide a long-term, a lifelong punishment in one instance, then that means the government should have the power to do so in other situations as well. So, I mean, I think you would have a hard time arguing that we should get rid of this, we should allow felons to get their firearms rights back, gun rights back, but then say that, oh, the government should be able to implement a long-term, lifetime penalty for another group of people as well. My biggest concern is that, okay, what are most felons going to do? Just because somebody hasn't been convicted of a felony in a long time, even 10 years, that doesn't mean that they're not still engaging in wrongdoing. And just because they haven't been convicted, they could still be doing some criminal activity. And if we allow them to legally carry firearms, what happens once they go out and do something stupid with those firearms? They're going to try to group people like me, the people who have never been convicted of felonies or misdemeanors or anything like that, and with the people who have been convicted of felonies. So it will make it easier for people to say, oh, see, this is what these gun people do, by saying, oh, well, this guy was a legal gun owner. Well, right now, we have a different standard in place, so it's a little bit harder to really attack all gun owners. But what happens once we all get put into the same category when they legalize gun ownership for convicted felons? Do you support legalizing gun ownership for convicted felons? I mean, obviously, personally, I don't see how it would benefit me personally, but it has to go beyond me. But share your thoughts on this. Should convicted felons have their voting rights restored? What do you think about that as well? Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.